Good morning, dear students, and welcome to our next chapter in science, which is measurement and effects of heat. Students, we have already learned about the various sources of heat around us in our previous years. The sun, our earth, chemical reactions which take place, electricity, atomic reactions, and the air around us, all of these things can contribute to the production of heat. So all of these are called as sources of heat. So let us now understand about each of them in detail. First, we begin with the sun. The sun is the biggest source of heat received by the earth. The sun produces a large amount of heat due to the continuous nucleus fissions which take place in the center of the earth. Some of this heat and light reaches the earth. The heat energy obtained from the sun is called as the solar energy. Second, our earth. You must have studied about the internal structure of the earth in geography. So you must be well aware that the temperature at the center of the earth is extremely high. So our earth is also a source of energy. The heat energy that is obtained from the earth is called geothermal energy. Next is chemical energy. When we burn things like wood, coal, petrol, kerosene, diesel, etc., there is a chemical reaction that takes place during the burning process, which is called as combustion. So this also releases heat. Next is electrical energy. In our day-to-day life, we use several equipments which produce heat. For example, iron for ironing our clothes, geyser for heating up water, microwave for heating food, oven for baking, induction gas for cooking, etc. So here, electricity is used to produce the heat. Next is atomic energy. We are aware that various atomic research centers are present where various research is done with regards to atomic energy. For example, the BARC or the Baba Atomic Research Center. Here, elements like uranium, thorium, etc. are used for various chemical reactions. The energy produced is called as atomic energy, which also generates a lot of heat. Last, we have air. We can easily experience the heat present in the air during the summer months when we feel that the air around us is warm. So, a large amount of heat is also present in the air around us. Next, let us understand what we mean by heat and temperature. Heat means the transfer of thermal energy between molecules within a substance. Heat is measured in joules. Heat measures how much energy moves or flow. Now, temperature is used to measure about the heat present within a substance. Temperature is measured in Celsius, which is degree Celsius, or Kelvin, K, or Fahrenheit, degree F. Next, let us look at what we mean by relative sensation. You must have realized at times in winter, you may be feeling very cold and need a sweater or warm clothes. But your friends are not feeling cold at all. On the other hand, at times in summer, you may be feeling very hot and sweaty, but your friend is feeling comfortable. Why does this happen? It happens due to something called as relative sensation of heat. We cannot determine the exact temperature of an object accurately simply by touching it. Hence, we need specific instruments to measure temperature. For that, we have special instruments that help us to know and to measure the exact temperature. So let us have a look at the first instrument. It is called as a thermometer. You must have seen a thermometer when someone is having fever at home, or you must have seen it with a doctor who wants to measure your body temperature. Such thermometers used to measure the temperature of a human body is called a clinical thermometer. Now, due to coronavirus, we have seen the use of a contactless thermometer being used. It measures the body temperature using infrared technology. In the given slide, the first picture is of a clinical thermometer usually used in houses or by doctors. The second picture is of a contactless thermometer which is now very widely used. The third picture is of a digital thermometer. In this, the body temperature is displayed using digital numbers. And in the fourth picture, it is a thermometer which is usually used in laboratories. The next instrument we have here is called a calorimeter. A calorimeter is used to measure the heat content of an object. Using this equipment, we can measure the heat produced or absorbed in a physical or chemical process. A calorimeter looks very similar to a thermos flask. It is made up of two vessels. The inner vessel is usually made up of copper. In a calorimeter, there is a thermometer present for measuring the temperature and a stirrer which is present for stirring the liquid in the calorimeter. Next, let us understand the effect of heat energy on solid substances. Solid substances can either expand when it is heated or they can contract when they are cooled down. Different metals can expand or contract at different times and by different amounts. It is not required that all types of metals can expand at the same temperature or they can contract at the same temperature. It can happen as per their own properties at different temperatures. Some examples we see over here. Railway tracks can expand when it is very hot, especially during the summer season, if there is no gap left between the railway tracks. If you see there in the picture, there is a gap which is present in the railway track. If this gap is not present, then the trains can get easily derailed and the train can get off the track, which will put the life of the passengers in danger. Second, bridges are fitted with rollers to allow expansion and contraction of the bridge. It allows the bridge to slide over them smoothly when expanded. Also, the overhead cables and the telephone lines expand during hot season and contract during cold season. And due to which, during the summer season, if you see the electric poles, you may see them stretched and very tight. But during winter seasons, you might see them hanging loosely because of contraction. So this is the effect of heat energy on solid substances. Next, we look at the effect of heat energy on liquid. Now, almost all liquids expand when it is heated and contract when it is cooled down. Cold drink factories usually need to allow space when filling up their bottles or cans. So whenever you get any cold drink bottles or cold drink cans, you might see that there is some amount of space, empty space, which is left in the bottle or in the can. This is required because when it is hot, the liquid may expand, and if there is no space for expanding, then it can crush the bottle or it can crush the can. Third one, no allowance will cause the bottle or the cans to burst. So that's what I said. If there is no space left, no empty space left in the bottle or the can, it can easily burst when the liquid expands. Finally, let us look at the effect of heat energy on gases. Gases also expand when heated and contract when cooled. Gases expand and contract much more than solids and liquid of the same volume for the same change in temperature. Means when you have any gaseous substance which is filled up in bottles or in cans, the amount of empty space which is required for the expansion of the bottles is much more. And if you have ever observed or seen anything written on your cans, especially your perfume cans or your perfume bottles, it is written over there that they are pressurized cans, and do not burn those cans, do not try to open those cans or do not try to burn those cans, because what will happen is that if the can is burned, then the gas which is present inside that particular inside that particular can, it will start expanding too much, and what will happen is that it can cause the can to burst, and if it is in the hand of any person, that person will be very badly injured. So with this, dear students, we come to the end of this particular chapter. Till we meet again, students, stay happy, stay safe. Bye.